Hello everyone. In this video, I'll discuss about the uses of price elasticity of demand, that how producers or the governments, they can use this concept to benefit their different areas. So the first point is that this concept can be helpful for the producers to calculate their total revenue and expenditure. For instance, if the producer knows that the demand for his product is elastic, he would decrease the price. And he can easily calculate that what is the gain in the total revenue. And in case of inelastic, producers would increase the price and they can calculate the effect on total revenue and its consumer's expenditure. Producers can use this concept for a price discrimination. For instance, during the peak hours, the demand for the product or service would be inelastic. So producers are going to charge higher prices. But during non-peak hours, to attract customers, they'll be charging lower prices. So in this case, the elasticity concepts would be applicable, that they can charge different pricing strategies according to the elasticity. For the imposition of taxes, the government has to see that what is the elasticity of demand for different products. If tax is imposed on the products those have inelastic demand, then government is going to get good revenue. Otherwise, it becomes difficult. Now let me show you the effect of indirect tax in the form of diagram. For instance, if there will be GST imposed on specific product, supply curve will shift backwards. So this will be the new equilibrium. Now this is the whole part which is going in the tax to the government. And who is going to pay? Definitely the whole amount is not paid by the producers. This upper part is paid by the consumers and this lower part is paid by the producers. Now these are the normal supply and demand curves I have drawn. If I'll make it flatter or I'll make it steeper, so you can see the changes in the contribution of the taxes paid by these two parties. So this is what producers have to see when they are passing on the burden of taxes, that who is going to pay more. Fourthly, producers have to see when they are introducing any incentives or promotion strategies for the consumers, that what is the elasticity of demand for the product. If it's elastic, then of course it would be an incentive for the customers to have decrease in prices. But otherwise it would not be effective. So producers, they have to make sure also that they know the elasticity of demand for their product. This concept is also helpful for determining the price stability of different types of products. Now this is the graph for manufactured goods. The demand for the manufactured goods is elastic, which means due to any changes, small changes in price, there will be major change in demand. So you can see that there will be more fluctuations in the prices. In case of primary products, those are agriculture products or raw material for the businesses, demand for these products is inelastic, which means due to any major changes in price, there will be minor changes in quantity demanded. So you can see more fluctuations in the price level of primary goods. Now with the help of shifting in the demand curve, we will see that what will be the price volatility in case of manufactured goods and primary goods. So you can see that the elastic supply curve shows that there is due to any change in price, there'll be major change in supply, which is possible in case of manufactured goods, that producers can arrange more factors of production and they can increase production easily. And there are less fluctuations in case of price. But for the primary products, it becomes very difficult to increase up supply whenever there is high demand, because there is a whole cycle which has to be completed to grow new crops. So you can see that due to any changes in price, there will be more fluctuations in price of the primary products. Limitations of price elasticity of demand. First of all, it's very difficult for the businesses to calculate price elasticity of demand. It's to see this, that at what price, how many units were sold, because there's not a single price which businesses charges. They keep on changing the pricing strategy, so it means that there will be different prices. And then how much quantity was sold on what price, this becomes very difficult. Secondly, it all depends on the past data. If we are calculating any elasticity for any product, it is on the basis of past. Future is uncertain. In future things might change, so it means this cannot be applicable for the future decisions. Thirdly, customer preferences might change. the taste of the customer, their choices, there'll be new products in the market, they might become more sensitive towards the price, less sensitive towards the price. So these things we are not taking into account when we are calculating price elasticity of demand. Then the fourth and most important is ceteris paribus. This is the condition which we take whenever we talk about price and quantity demanded relationship. We take a lot of other factors constant, but it is not possible. In the real world, in the dynamic world, things keep on changing. Your competitors, new competitors, government policies. So we have to take these into account. Otherwise, it limits the use of this price elasticity of demand concept. Lastly, even the price elasticity of demand is not constant along the same demand curve. At the top, it will be perfectly elastic. Then it will be elastic, unitary elastic, inelastic, and perfectly inelastic. So if the business is assuming that they have elastic demand and it would remain elastic throughout the specific time period, it is not possible. Again, these limitations would restrict the use of this concept of price elasticity of demand completely for any business. That's all for today. In the next video, I'll talk about the price elasticity of supply. Thank you for watching the video. Hello everyone. In this video, we will calculate price elasticity of demand. Now, whenever examiners pose you this question of calculation, there will be always given two pairs of price and quantity demanded. For instance, at $10, the quantity demanded is 1000, and then at 12, quantity demanded decreases to 500. Formula is percentage change in quantity demanded divided by percentage change in price. So if I will have the extension of this, it means change in quantity demanded divided by original quantity. So my change of quantity demanded is 500. Which means 500 minus 1000, and original is 1000 multiplied by 100. And I would ignore negative sign. So whenever you calculate this, you have to ignore a negative sign. Divided by the same way, price, change in price, original price multiplied by 100. You can take values from there. 2 divided by 10 multiplied by 100. The answer comes out 2.5. Now, when you people have to do interpretation of this answer, you have to tell clearly that for this product, either it has elastic demand, inelastic, or unitary elastic. So this is the criteria you people have. If the answer comes out equal to 1, it means it's unitary elastic. If answer is greater than 1, it means it's elastic. And if the answer is less than 1, it means it has inelastic demand. So we have come to know that for the product for which we have calculated this price elasticity of demand, it has elastic demand. Now I have a question. From your previous videos, I explained to you people that if it has elastic demand, what type of curve we make for a demand, either flatter or steeper. The answer, you have to think, you have to pause, you have to think and see the answer in the first comment. Hello everyone. In this video, we will calculate price elasticity of demand. Now, whenever examiners pose you this question of calculation, there will be always given two pairs of price and quantity demanded. For instance, at $10, the quantity demanded is 1000, and then at 12, quantity demanded decreases to 500. Formula is percentage change in quantity demanded divided by percentage change in price. So if I will have the extension of this, it means change in quantity demanded divided by original quantity. So my change of quantity demanded is 500, which means 500 minus 1000, and original is 1000 multiplied by 100. And I would ignore negative sign. So whenever you calculate this, you have to ignore a negative sign. Divided by the same way, price, change in price, original price multiplied by 100. You can take values from there. 2 divided by 10 multiplied by 100. The answer comes out 2.5. Now, when you people have to do interpretation of this answer, you have to tell clearly that for this product, either it has elastic demand, inelastic, or unitary elastic. So this is the criteria you people have. If the answer comes out equal to 1, it means it's unitary elastic. If answer is greater than 1, it means it's elastic. And if the answer is less than 1, it means it has inelastic demand. So we have come to know that for the product for which we have calculated this price elasticity of demand, it has elastic demand. Now I have a question. From your previous videos, I explained to you people that if it has elastic demand, what type of curve we make for a demand, either flatter or steeper. The answer, you have to think, you have to pause, you have to think and see the answer in the first comment. Hello everyone, in this video we will calculate price elasticity of demand. Now whenever examiners pose you this question of calculation, there will be always given two pairs of price and quantity demanded. For instance, at $10 the quantity demanded is 1000 and then at 12 quantity demanded decreases to 500. Formula is percentage change in quantity demanded divided by percentage change in price. So if I will have the extension of this, it means change in quantity demanded divided by original quantity. So my change of quantity demanded is 500, which means 500 minus 1000, and original is 1000 multiplied by 100. And I would ignore negative sign. So whenever you calculate this, you have to ignore a negative sign. Divided by the same way, price, change in price, original price multiplied by 100. You can take values from there, 2 divided by 10 multiplied by 100. The answer comes out 2.5. Now, when you people have to do interpretation of this answer, you have to tell clearly that for this product, either it has elastic demand, inelastic or unitary elastic. So this is the criteria you people have. If the answer comes out equal to 1, it means it's unitary elastic. If answer is greater than 1, it means it's elastic. And if the answer is less than 1, it means it has inelastic demand. So we have come to know that for the product for which we have calculated this price elasticity of demand, it has elastic demand. Now I have a question. From your previous videos, I explained to you people that if it has elastic demand, what type of curve we make for a demand, either flatter or steeper. The answer, you have to think, you have to pause, you have to think and see the answer in the first comment.